the reason we chose the Mayfly data logger hardware is because it's low cost and you can do it yourself and it's flexible. So the Mayfly board itself costs $60 and the cellular modem costs $95. So the hardware is inexpensive, and we were interested in learning about this technology, how to program data loggers, and building our skills so that we could have more flexibility in how we monitor the environment. Just to start with some of the hardware, I have laid out a few different types of batteries that you can use to power your system. They're all lithium ion batteries providing 3.7 volts. This is a, you know, bare Mayfly board. The board has a central processing unit. It's got a battery to maintain a clock. It's got an SD card to collect data. It's got an on and off switch and a sensor testing button. When I put together a complete system, it's all housed within a Pelican case. I add a mending plate to the back of the Pelican case so that I can mount it on a pole. Use some rubber washers and some small screws to get that connected. And then with similar hardware, I mount a solar panel on the back. So you can see the rubber on these washers creates an airtight seal. This is a solar panel. And it has a wire that sends the charge to this connector on the board. There's three power connectors, one for being charged by the solar panel, one to send power to the cellular modem, and one to draw power from the battery. This is the size of battery that I use for this system. As rain falls and is collected in the tipping bucket sends this magnet past this reed switch, and that creates a signal which goes down through this gray wire. Gray wire comes out and it goes through a cable gland in the bottom of the Pelican case. Cable gland provides a watertight way to get cables into this case. So the signal wire doesn't connect directly to the Mayfly in this system. It first goes through a pro trinket. The pro trinket has one job, which is to count the signals, count the tips. So as the pro trinket counts the tips, you can see the Mayfly sends the data. Right now it's doing one of its data transmissions using this purple modem, this green adapter. These lights indicate that it's connected, it's got a good signal, and it's sending data. And it uses a micro SIM card with a hologram data plan to send the data to a website. This system has a small antenna for the radio. So the lights turned off. That means the data transmission is complete. So I should be able to update my browser and see the most recent data. So you can see that at 12:20, which is actually 1:20, there were four tips. So when I was tipping the rain gauge, it was being counted by the pro trinket, logged by the Mayfly data logger and transmitted by the cellular modem. And then the internet got the data and the website from EnviroDIY, monitor my watershed, ingested that data into the database and displays it so that we can see. And this data is accessible on your phone. So if you have a phone, you can navigate to this website. It's public, so you can see this data on your phone through this website. One of the reasons we chose this setup is because it means that you can constantly monitor how the hardware is functioning in the field. So if you've got a thunderstorm, you can immediately see how much water came down during that thunderstorm. You don't have to go out to the site and download the data. You can look it up on your phone. And it's also useful for troubleshooting. To be able to see live data, you can know right away when one of your stations isn't working. So that can be a signal for you to go out and unclog the rain gauge or change the battery. It took a number of hours to learn this. I didn't have any programming experience in this language before I started. So we had a formal 8-hour training where we went over the software, how to load a program onto the data logger, and how to make changes to programs. And then after that 8 hours of training, we spent a lot of time developing our own programs and getting them to work. There's a lot of little things to learn. So it's not a quick process, but it's rewarding when you can get things to work. And the way that this community and these systems are set up, there are online forums where you can ask the people who designed this, you know, questions about problems that you're having with your setup. And they're very responsive, and you can read through all the other questions that other people have posted to learn how to do this sort of thing.